Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm coming with another envelope craft project or tutorial or sharing. It will be multi-pocket from this DL envelope, that long one. It's like top loaded long. And it looks like this. It has pocket here. It has pocket here, and I also made sliding window here, where is window where you can see through. You don't have to do this sliding top. You can make it just like page, but that base looks like this. It's made from envelope and one cardstock. Here you can see that background for the pocket here. Here is pocket on this side, and again, there is a window. That's why I'm using this window envelope, because I like to see, you know, from one side, I like to see what is inside. And it's not too hard. What you will need, it's some DL envelope and also cardstock. And it's good to use some stronger paper to, if you want to do this this top sliding tip, but I will show you where you can stop and you will have two pockets and also top page. So you need DL envelope. There are several different sizes of these envelopes. I will show you this one. I will tell you also measurement of this one. My envelope measure, this envelope measure 9 1/4 by 4 1/2. Here I made it from a little bit smaller envelope. It was also DL envelope, but just a bit smaller. So you can see that here, that it was slightly smaller here on this side and slightly shorter. So you can do it with any size of this DL envelope. First, what we gonna do, it's glued that envelope together, and that one of these pockets I found kind of accidentally when I already tried to take this tutorial. I had there only one pocket and that top slide thing, and accidentally I cut it wrong, and I was like, you, I can do another pocket. So it was happy accident. Bob Ross happy accident. I'm gonna place my window close to start of scoring to keep that window inside. And I'm gonna score 5 inches. 5 inches here. If you don't have window, if you don't have envelope with window, just score it from one side 5 inches. Here I do have that top, but because it's glued, it doesn't matter, really, it doesn't matter. But if you have window, put window to the start of your scoring board, or start, you know, of your scoring board, and then score 5 inches. And that all scoring for now. All scoring for now. Then you need to open that envelope. Good slight piece from this edge. Just small piece from that edge. And then with scissors, cut those sides to that score line here, just to that score line, and here on that opposite side as well, just to that score line. Not where is that window, not on those 5 inches, on that rest. You will have something like this. You will have pocket here to that window, and you will have those two pages, and here that pocket. So what are we gonna do now? If you have that window, keep it to to the top, and this bottom side could half inch from the pocket, half inch, or just strip, it will be fold underneath, half inch, take your scissors and cut those corners like this, cut and cut. We are now making those folds for that back pocket. So we've got one, and then this rest cut on 1 inch strips. One and two pieces. Keep that rest. You can fold them by hand, or if you need to have score line, just score them on half inch and then fold it like this. I'm gonna fold those ends together, and here it's opening, so I'm gonna cut, you know, those angles here. This is my envelope. Here is that pocket, side pocket, here. So I'm gonna take this one fold. I'm gonna take a glue and glue it here on this side. I need to see. I hope you will don't see my head in there. So we've got one set of one fold, another fold, and I wanna create also this bottom one. So I'm gonna fold this other piece as well. Again, I'm gonna cut, here is opening, so I'm gonna cut those ends a little bit. I'm gonna put the glue here. Oi! Push. And glue it here on the bottom. So we have prepared that one back side pocket. Then when you will place it to your journal, just put glue here, here and here, and glue it on your journal page. This last piece I fold it on the half like this. I could slide piece from the edge to make it just a little bit smaller, just slide piece, just piece like this, really slide piece from one edge, and then with my scissors here is open, okay? So I fold it together. I didn't press it here, I just put those two corners together, and with my scissors I cut it a little bit decorative. Just a little bit. You can use envelope punch board or some decorative scissors. Then I open it so it looks like this one. I cut those corners here where is fold, okay? I open it. I put glue here. And where is that? Here is that top. Here we've got that back side pocket. So where is this inside pocket? I slide this piece inside like this and glue it inside. Not all inside. I just let it peeking out a little bit here and here. And I fold this to that back. And fold it over. So I made like a better entry to that pocket. It's much more easy to find that pocket and to see that pocket. That's why I made this tab here. And now you can already glue it to your journals, decorate, distress it, or put it to coffee dye it or tea dye it. It's too late now. I think I'm too tired. Sorry. Coffee dye it, tea dye it. Then you can place it on your page in your journal, glue it down, and you've got side pocket and top loaded pocket. And here you've got writing page, and here you've got beautiful window. So you can stop to work on this one right now. But if you want that moving part, now it will be a little bit more work, but it's not too hard to do. It's not too hard, really. And this piece is here just for me to put it all together. So that was just, maybe I don't even have to do it, but you know, it's what I made, so I'm gonna share what I made. I'm not gonna say that this one is the best one. And I think I just glued something inside. Eh. Good. So what I made to do that sliding thing. I open it this page on my envelope. I took the ruler and I draw. I'm gonna distress it a little bit, so you will, I'm gonna not distress it because I can't fold it right now. I'm gonna draw lines so you will see. Here it's fold, okay? Here is this fold, this one. So from that fold, I made lines, line 3/4 inch. 3/4 inch, and I draw a line. Then both sides, I did same. 3/4 inch here. 3/4 inch. 3/4 inch, and here 3/4 inch. And again, I draw lines like this. And like this. And then, so you have something like this, pattern like this. Then I took my scissors and I cut with my scissors here. Here and here. This I made just to somehow, you know, put that decor together. That was only why I made all this. So right now you will need some cardstock, and here I will probably recommend some stronger cardstock. And we will cut piece which will be fitted inside, which will make that moving part. This, it's 5 inches long, and this is 4.5, I think I said. Yes, 4.5. So I'm gonna cut a strip of my cardstock 5 inch first. 5. And this is 4.5. This side, and I need 2 folds which I will use to glue it, all that moving part, on this envelope. So 4.5, and I will use 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch on both sides, so it's all together, it's 5.5. So I do have my cardstock. Now I'm gonna take scoring board again, and on that 5.5 inches long side, I'm gonna score, oops, not on, here I've got those 5.5, so I'm gonna score, where is that pattern, 1/2 inch from one side, 1/2 inch from one side, flip it over, and 1/2 inch again. Like this. I'm gonna have a look if I made it right, if I can fit it here. I it should be exactly, it is exactly like this. So now I need to do that moving part. For that, I draw it from inside. I took again my ruler. I know, it's so many, so many. I'm sorry for that. And I draw from those folds from here. Here is that fold. So from that fold, I draw again 3/4 inch. 3/4. 3/4. Like this. And from that other side, where is that? Here is that fold. So from that fold again, 3/4 inch. 3/4. 3/4. And draw the line. And then I took my scoring tool, scoring board. It looks like this. Here I do have my folds, here and here. So I place it like this on my scoring board. And then I scored 3/4 inch. I went very lightly in that line. And where is starting this line, I pressed a little bit more and I scored 3/4 inch just between my drawing here, just between that drawing, and same I made on that opposite side, 3/4 inch again. I went very lightly here, make sure that I will don't press too much, and here I scored 3/4 inch. Then I took my scissors. Maybe you can do it much more easy way. I'm not sure how those slide things are made. I just know I saw them, so I was thinking how probably they make it. I'm not sure how they make it. Probably this is maybe very confusing. I'm not sure. I'm just showing what I made. Fold it on one fold, one score line, fold that other score line as well, and then fold this to that first score line, and press it down, like this. So we have that moving base, and because I was very worried if there will be enough space, I cut a little bit here those corners, just a little bit, and then I could tack for my moving part. And I could tack because this is 4.5 exactly the size of my envelope. So I could strip off cardstock 4 3/8. 4 3/8. Like this, so I can fit it inside, but it will be not too loose. See, it will be just enough so I can move it easily in this one. And then because my envelope from here till here it's 5 inches, I cut it 5.5. I wanted there that edge to see a part of this tack outside, so I cut it 5.5. So I do have my base. On one side of that 5.5, on one side I used envelope punch board, and I cut those corners to make it look like tack, like this. Then I took my mechanism I flip it over. I place that tag inside. And I forgot before we will do anything, this last thing to make sure I will be possible for me, it will be possible to flat it down on my page. All that moving part when it will be decorated. Where is it? Here is it. So it's flat. It's totally flat. So to make sure that I will be able to move it to the end, I could with my scissors just slide piece from this edge, just very slight strip, and I try to keep it, you know, straight. Even my cutting, it's terrible. I try to keep it straight. Then I put that tag inside. Of course, after I distress it or coffee dye it or decorate it with some decorative paper, I moved that tag on the end of this sliding thing on the end. Then I made sure that here is it kind of similar. I flipped this over, just that edge. Put there glue like this and flip it back, just like this, nothing else. Then I took my envelope, and before I glued this on the top, you can use some stamping. So you can use some stencils, you can use some beautiful image and place it here. Here you can see where is the edge of that moving part. So where you can start stamping, here you will have window like this scene. So here you can start stamping something on or put there some image. I place there just this picture. So if you would like to make some stenciling, stamping or so, do it now. Then I took this mechanism, I flip it over, put glue here. And I will put this to coffee, I will coffee dye it, so I'm not gonna stamp anything, I'm not gonna glue anything. It will be all coffee dye or tea dye, something. And I place it here, from the edge to the edge. Lift it up, place that upon on opposite side. To make sure I am straight with all those edges. Flat it down and press all those edges. Then flip this over to check it out. And it looks good. And because this is just super simple envelope, which can be very weak, it will be very soft. And it's 3/4 inch, this one. So I could strip of paper. I think it's this from that edge, yes. And I could 3/4 inch strip of paper. And I made like bridge. I put glue here and here. Not inside, just here and here. I placed here this strip of paper from the side like this. Then I put glue on all these parts. Like this. Hey. So it's not too hard. As you can see, it's not too hard. And I flip it over. I just make sure that I'm not gonna glue this paper on that moving part. So it's not too hard, really. And I'm not sure why I made this one, but I made it. And we have our moving part ready to go. So now I can place it to tea or coffee. Then I can decorate it with all kinds of stuff. And I can slide it in. So it looks like this. So we've got pocket here. When we will glue it here and here and here. So it will be pocket from here. And it does have this moving part. When you will plan to decorate it, remember very important thing. It depends which way you would like to put your envelope. Maybe, or that multi-pocket thing. Maybe you would like to place it this way, so you will have pocket from here, and that moving part will be here. So you will probably want to have some image like this, which will stand up. Just remember, do not place that image over that fold. Here, this fold. Do not place that image over, and do not glue it on this part. Glue it just here. I could from normal cardboard, I cut piece, which is under this one. I think I'm gonna... Here. I hope you can see here, that brown piece. It's this cardboard. I cut the piece, which will fit into this part, like this. Not too big. I place it here, and then on that I glued this composition. And if you will notice here, I do have that fold. I couldn't place it far, because if I will place it a little bit far from that fold, that image will be like my break, and I will be not able to lift it up. So, when you will plan how you will place this this pocket to your page, make sure you will don't put it over the fold here. Or maybe you will want to place it to your journal this way. So, you will have pocket with that window here. You will have another pocket here. And this will lift this way. So, you will have an image here. Like this. So, again... Fix your image only on half of that fold, and do not place it over. Fix your image here, and do not place it over this fold. Make some composition which will stand up when you will move this tack down. Or you will have it like me here. So always make attention how you will put your image. And if I will want to put this image this way, but to open, to move to this side, not like here to this side, but on this side, I will glue it not on this half. I'm gonna flat it down. Here I glued this image on this. And if I will want to have it open this way, so I will put this one here, and then this corner will match this fold, like this. So then, you know what, I'm gonna very quickly, it's paper, I can rip it off, you know. I'm not afraid to rip it off. I will place it here, and then I will pay attention when I will glue that tack on it. That tack, I would like to place it this way. I would like to see that tack up front of me like this. But then I would like to have that tack open this way. So this cardstock is here. And when I will glue down that tack, I have to pay attention on this fold. Here it doesn't matter if it will be down or up. But this fold is very important. I will place it like this to make sure I can see a bit of that fold. If I will place it this way, I will show you. If I will glue it like this, then when I will wanna open it, see? It's not glued, but it's not glued. Maybe it will hold. Now, it will break your image if you will glue it over the fold. And same it will be if you will have that image this way and you will place it too far from that fold. So it will, you know, break your image. So pay attention which way. But you can use this pocket many different ways. So you will have, here we've got this pocket. You can place it here. You can have pocket here and slide it up. So this is multifunctional. And I really love that. But maybe it's not most easy way how I am doing it. That's possible. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. I hope that someone from you will actually try it, because I it's really cute, you know. It's cute opening. You've got there that window so you can see what you've got in one pocket. But yay, you've got here another pocket. And you've got, yay, moving picture. I always love to see some moving pocket. And now I stick. Okay. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your patience with me. I hope you have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.